Hey everybody, it is Kat, Kat on Point. Thanks for coming back. And if you're new here, welcome. I hope you decide to stay. So anyway, I want to thank Danielle Nicole for inviting me to this collab. This is a collaboration video. So there's a lot of other wonderful people who are participating in this collab. The collab is called My Favorite Crockpot Recipe. Please go check them out. They're going to have wonderful recipes, and you can just make a folder in your YouTube account and stick them all in there under Crockpot Recipes, and you'll have something to find every time you're looking for a Crockpot recipe. Mine is a Greek-inspired chicken dish, and I thought if it's not absolutely fabulous, I'm not going to share it. Guess what? It's absolutely fabulous, and I love it, so I'm going to share it. It's a really good basic recipe that you could use in many other dishes. It's a really tender chicken, shreds really well. You can be able to freeze it and use it in all kinds of other things, but it works really good in a pita with some tzatziki sauce. It was wonderful. And I made some lentil soup in my Instant Pot to go with it. It was a wonderful, wonderful dinner. And I would have to say it probably was at least as good as, if not better, than something that I've had at my favorite Mediterranean restaurant. So I highly recommend it. And I hope this goes into your YouTube Crock-Pot collection. Okay, so again, thanks Danielle Nicole for inviting me to this collab. And let's get started. All right, one of the reasons why I love this recipe so much is because it's simple ingredients, and just a few ingredients make it kapow, just really melt in your mouth flavor. Okay, so first off, we have 2 pounds of boneless, skinless chicken breasts or boneless chicken tenders. I'm using some from Costco here. They've been defrosting in the fridge. Now, the recipe calls for 3 cloves of garlic, but you know I love garlic, so I'm going to double that, and I'm going to use 6. 2 teaspoons of red wine vinegar, and then the juice of 1 lemon. I'm using the Faye yogurt. We need 1/2 cup of that, of Greek yogurt, and about 2 to 3 tablespoons of olive oil. Now for our spices, we're going to be using some 2 teaspoons of dried oregano. And the recipe called for 2 to 4 teaspoons of Greek seasoning. I didn't have that, but I'm using this za'atar. This is a really good, actually, I think this probably even worked out better. There's the ingredients in case you want to see it. But you know, you can pick this up almost anywhere. And, you know, it works real good on roasted pitas, but it works great in this recipe. And you're going to be using 2 tablespoons of dill reed, which I thought was a lot, but come to find out, it was just the right amount. All right, super duper easy recipe. Just throw it all in the crock pot. This is everything. This is what it looks like when it first goes in there. And then you're just going to grab a big spoon and just kind of like mix it all together. And then I'll show you what that looks like here. So this is it all mixed up together. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cook it on low for about 6 hours. You can go on high for about 4 hours, but it's gonna be a while till I use it. Okay, so here it is, it's all done. And oh my goodness, it is so tender, you guys. And my house smells so delicious right now. Look how it just falls apart. Now I'm just going to mix this all around so it gets, you know, really nice and juicy with all that good stuff. And it's just going to soak up all those wonderful flavors. Look at that. It was so amazing. I've got some nice soft pitas here. They're whole wheat, and I'm going to serve them with a little bit of tzatziki sauce, some fresh tomatoes, and some more red onion. And here's my tzatziki sauce. Now, of course, I've got my, you know, measuring tablespoon in there. 2 tablespoons is a serving. Now, cucumbers would be great in here, but I didn't have any. And I made a big pot of lentil soup to go with it. Absolutely wonderful. So most of the points are going to come from the nice, soft, wonderful, yummy pita itself. Other than that, it's pretty low on points. I'll put them up on the screen. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed that recipe as much as I did and as much as I will. My family loves it. It's absolutely marvelous. So again, I want to encourage you to go down into the description box and check out all those other wonderful contributors to this collab. You're going to really enjoy it. Okay, guys, I hope I see you next time. Take care. Thank you.